Hey, what's going on, everybody? This is Alan Anthony from Phone Tech at Work, and today we're going to take a look at the camera settings on your LG V40. Nothing technical, but just a basic run through so you see what you get. So let's start the video, show you what I'm talking about. Pop. All right, guys, so basically you just hit the camera, and now we're going to run through a little bit of everything that you get with your camera lens. See if we could zoom in just a little bit there. So you have the Google Lens, which is basically something that you could tap and you could check like a Google search, and it will actually bring up a whole bunch of stuff. So let me head it back there. Google Lens, let's see if it pops up the Pixel Stand. You just tap it, then it should make like a result. Now, it's not 100% accurate. Don't know what that is, but that was pretty funny. And just head back and you do it as well. Portrait mode, you guys already know what that is. That has to do with like the bokeh and blurring out the background. So you can do that in portrait mode. So triple shot. Triple shot is basically where it's taking advantage of the three lenses that you have in the back of the phone, where it'll take advantage of the telephoto lens, which is basically like you're zooming in without actually losing quality, which is pretty good. And it takes advantage of the standard lens and the super wide angle lens. So if you just press triple shot, right, and you click it, it takes a little while to actually finish. But what exactly happens after it renders up is it takes a little short video, and you're able to post it on Facebook if you want to, but it does take three photos as well. So this is what I don't like about it, is that first shot is always like wrong, but the next two is always pretty good. As you guys can see, you got the whole frame in there right there. So let's head back into the next shot. So we do have the AI cam, which will basically, it'll try to distinguish the scene and what you want your filter to be, basically, where it's going to add filters and just do everything that it wants to. And you could add your personal filters as well. So if I did have like a sandwich right here, I will point to it with the AI cam, and it will turn on like the food mode or whatever, which is pretty dope. So if you guys are interested in this right here, so you got, that's the little telephoto lens, that's the standard lens, and that's the super ultra wide angle lens, which is freaking awesome. Okay, so let's just see what this little arrow does right there. You press it and you're able to share on your social media if you want to, just like that. So let's head into the actual settings, which is on the top left. So you have super bright camera, take bright and clear photos in the dark, not available in 4K and 60 frames per second. So you're able to adjust that, which is pretty cool. You can do it as manual, auto, HDR is right there. HDR corrects backlight with multiple exposure settings, so you can make that manual, or well, it's on, off, or auto. Steady recording to reduce motion and blur in videos. So if you have any person moving in the photos, it will try to keep it steady as possible. Live photo is basically the same thing that you get with iPhones, and I think with the Pixel now, where it takes 2 seconds shot before the photo is actually taken, so you're able to actually see the video or whatever. And it does actually work on iPhone, so if you try to send that to an iPhone, it does actually show up as a live photo. Cheese shutter, you basically say cheese, smile, whiskey, kimchi, or LG, and it actually takes the photo. I do have that off, but I'll turn that on. Tag locations, it'll basically tag your location that you're currently at, and it will tag it inside your photos and try to customize it in your album. So grid is basically, you have like a little grid when you're taking your photo, so you can make everything nice and neat. It's totally up to you. And your signature is where you can add your own name, and you can definitely customize it. There's a few fonts here, but not too much. I put the V40 Thank You in case I want to do any type of picture comparison, so it's entirely up to you. So let's get back into the settings. So you're able to do full vision, which will basically take out all the borders that was there. I don't know why I didn't have that on to begin with, but it's pretty cool. So we have this right here. This is basically like your settings for your picture size. If you want it at the full potential with the 16 megapixels, it's only going to be 4x3. Or if you want to downgrade it to 12 megapixels, then you can have the 16x9. Like a lot of websites still use 16x9, but a lot of them don't. So if you want a nice wallpaper, you have to use the 18x9. It's entirely up to you, but that's what it is. So here's the video setting right here. Click that one up. And as you guys can see, we do have the 4K 60, which is pretty awesome. 16x9, we got 2K 1080p. I think it's thought I said kimchi, but it didn't. And now I said that. Okay, so I can't say those words. So back to the video settings. So we do have 720p. Okay, so you can't say any type of P words. All right. Timer, you guys already know what timer is. It'll basically make a timer for your phone. So, okay, so let's just head into mode, see what that's all about. So we have your manual mode. If you guys are interested in what that looks like, this is what it looks like. And if you guys are into camera and photography or into doing like a bunch of videos where you just want to customize how everything looks, like the white balance, like the ISO and all that good stuff, here's a little bit of a zoomed way of looking at it. You do have one for pictures and you have one for video as well. So if you want to customize your video, this is what that one looks like right there. Big shout out to Easy Computer Suits, and he does actually use this a lot. So, all right, so we have center video. We could press that right here. And as you guys can see, center effect looks preset. Use lookup tables, a way to alter colors in a video using a mathematical formula created with the help of film professionals to record high quality video resembling major motion picture. So yeah, so as you guys can see from that, let's see if we can do that from here. So you just tap it right there. If you're recording, you could customize the brightness, I guess, there from right there, and press that here. You watch it over, but it did have a little point zoom. So the point zoom, you could slowly go in and out as you're recording. So if I hit record, I could slowly zoom in, almost like I have like an Osmo or something. The quality is not downgraded at all. It actually looks pretty good because of this lighting here. But as you guys can see from the top, it is recording in HDR10, which is pretty dope. Now, I'm not sure if this one is C-Log or whatever, but I know there's a lot of customizations when it comes to that. Food, you guys already know what food is. So if you have a big burger or something, and if you want to make it look good, you can do that as well. Head back into mode. Slow motion, let's see how the slow motion is here. Tap the all part icon to switch between recording the entire video in slow motion or just part slow mode. The video will record as normal until you tap to slow it down. The shortest you could go is 0.5 seconds. The video can be slowed down up to 5 times, which is pretty good. So that's for quality. Basically doing slow motion, entirely up to you. Let's see if I can do something quick. So just play it back. It'll be played in slow motion, and you're able to slow it down. Looks like they added some music to it too. See what they did there? So you're able to turn that music off if you want to, or if you want to add a track, you can definitely do that as well. So there's some cool stuff with it. It's pretty awesome. Definitely digging that. So let's head back into the mode. The next one we're going to jump into is panorama. Panorama is basically a very long picture, so you just stay still. This has been around for so long, and you just take a whole picture. It's nothing too crazy. Flash jump cut. So let's see what this is. Photos are taken every 3 seconds and saved as a GIF. So basically a GIF maker. So let's get back to our flashlight. All right. I don't know. I never used any of these features, but it's pretty cool actually learning about it. So let's see exactly what happened here. Photos are saved as a GIF. So that's exactly what happened. So like a lot of people who do like the monkey faces, you definitely do that. Post it on your Facebook and make fun of them. All right, so flash jump cut is basically you're making another GIF, but it's being saved as something else. Should we do this again? Okay, so let's just try this again. Right there. All right, so let's see what it did. So if you want to make like a little cartoon, and you're probably way more better at this than me, but that's exactly what it does. So let's get into AR stickers. AR stickers are pretty cool. It's the same thing that you see with the Pixel 3 XL. It's telling me to move it around. Move around your device until a surface is found. All right, so we got the surface. So basically add these little things here. My son absolutely loves these things. And you could just add a whole bunch and just show it off or do whatever, put the money there, and everything will be in some type of AR stuff. It's pretty cool. And you're able to record it as well, so show your friends if you want to. Head back into mode, send a shot. All right, so we got filters. So filters right over there. Got all your different filters. Deep, pure, chic, calm, mellow, classic, bright, 1839, black and white, nostalgia, jade, and all that good stuff. So this is how you flip your camera back and forth, and this one is how to turn off your flash, just like that. All right, let's see if there's anything for the front facing camera. All right, so for the front facing camera, let's see what we got here. So we have Google Lens, portrait, AI cam, and you have your wide angle lens right here and your single lens right over there as well. Everything looks pretty much the same. It looks like you're able to add stickers, and you got filters as well, right there. So you want, oh wow, I don't know if you can do this. Hello, 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 hello. These are not as bad as AR emojis. Hello, pow. All right, so that's about it for the front facing stuff. You guys could definitely play with it if you guys have it, but if you guys don't have an iPhone, you're definitely not missing out. You could definitely try to do something here. So. All right, guys, so that's about it for the camera settings of the LG V40. Hope you guys enjoyed this long video. I never really do this many videos like this, but I definitely wanted to showcase how much features you get with the LG V40, and it's a lot. So if you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up and follow Phone Tech at Work for more videos like this. Peace and love. I'll see you guys in the next video. Later.